First it was the US, now parts of Europe are sweltering through a fierce heat wave, with temperatures in some countries set to reach almost 50 degrees.
More people have been evacuated from their homes on the Spanish island of Tenerife as a wildfire in the north of the island burns out of control.
Greece is reeling from a new fire tragedy tonight. Massive blazes are still tearing through the country. People are being told to stay inside to stay alive.
The climate crisis is spiraling out of control. Half measures will not prevent full climate breakdown.
The Northern Hemisphere suffering through its hottest August on record, the only month hotter, July.
This year is truly a record year. July might have been the hottest month in 120,000 years.
Temperatures in Greece hitting the mid-40s. Its August average, more like 30. Greece, a tinderbox. Wildfires forcing 20,000 to evacuate. Italy nudging 50 degrees, far exceeding its August average of 32. Sicily and Calabria alight. Spain's Catalonia region recording its highest recorded temperature, 45 degrees. Blazes on Spain's Canary Islands.
The sort of events that we've seen in Europe this summer will become more and more common. In fact, they'll probably look pretty average a decade from now, and the extremes will be things that we've never experienced.
Fires hitting 10 Mediterranean countries.
Incredible temperatures approaching 50 degrees, storm force winds, fire generated storms that rip trees out of the ground and pick up fire trucks, drop them on their roof.
2023, officially the second hottest year on record. Today, scientists warn the planet is now well outside the safe operating space for humanity, with 6 of 9 planetary boundaries now broken. The ability of key global systems like climate, water, and wildlife diversity to maintain a healthy planet at risk of failing.
We think as a human race we can deal with everything, well, we can't.
On top of all this, a message today that climate change is irreversibly altering the formation of Antarctic sea ice. Record lows earlier this year, likely to be repeated.
Without reducing fossil fuel usage and greenhouse gas emissions, the future looks pretty bleak for sea ice and all of the creatures that rely on it and its role in the global climate system.
Whenever we've come out of a triple La Nina in past years, were bad bushfire years, so it's almost certain we will have big fires. If they're coupled with heat waves, they could be very bad.
It is urgent. When we see the challenges that we face and the existential nature of those challenges, I do not think we can waste time.
It's a grim way to start a Thursday, isn't it? Oh, hello, Kate Langford.
Hello.
Nice to see you.
Hello.
You just have to see what's happening at the moment. It's pretty warm. We're 2 weeks into spring, but they're expecting 30 degrees in Sydney on the weekend. They're madly trying to hazard reduction burn at the moment because there's been so much fuel that's built up after a couple of years of rain, and already we're seeing high temperatures.
The problem is when temperatures get high this early, you can't even backburn.
That's it.
Because then the risk of backburning is that it'll get out of control. So then your hazard reduction can't happen. And it's just this, what's the opposite? A vicious cycle, I was going to say.
Yeah. So what's the answer?
Well, we know what the answer is. The question is, are we capable? I've always felt the thing with climate change is it's like the one catastrophe human beings are just not built to deal with because it's slow, it's abstract. Like, we're very good at dealing with immediate... terrorism. We go, OK, we know it's... Or a pandemic, we can shut everything down. Something's like this. It's just...
I was feeling that today, you know, reading about this and talking about it, it doesn't feel like we're capable of the urgency to do it. We see it, but it just keeps happening.
Because people don't know what to do. People are like, I'm using my recycling bin.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, there's no...
Some of these decisions are bigger than us.
Yes. I think that's a massive part of it.
Totally.
I think you're right, though. Frog in a pot boiling.
Yeah.